So welcome back to this first video game update for the PlayStation Vita. This is my collection, what I've been pretty much been collecting from last year, because this year I only got one game for the Vita. But I know a lot of games coming out this year. Some really cool games are coming out this year. I cannot freaking wait to finally play them and to get more use out of my PlayStation Vita, because I am definitely playing more PSP than my PlayStation Vita. I do have a good amount of games for the system. Not all of them are great, not all of them are AAAs, but not all of them are really bad. Some are good, some are bad, some are amazing. So let's just start up with something amazing, and that is Lumines Electronic Symphony. I freaking loved Lumines on my PSP, and it's just pretty much the same, more dubstep, crystal clear screen, this and that, but it's an amazing game. Same goes actually for Wipeout 2048. It's pretty much an upgrade from the PSP Wipeout or the PlayStation 3 Wipeout. It looks good, it sounds good, it plays good, it's just Wipeout. Resistance Burning Skies. The cutscenes in this game are more interesting than the entire story itself. The gameplay is good though. A shooter on a handheld can work. Ridge Racer. Mortal freaking Kombat. I freaking love this game. Graphically, I hoped for a better looking game compared to the PlayStation 3. You can definitely see they downgraded the graphics a lot. But the gameplay is still the same. It's absolutely freaking amazing. I love this game. Gravity Rush, one of the few new IPs that are actually good on a PlayStation Vita. I love the main character, I love the story, I love how the world looks, but this is a type of GTA game with an open world, and then you have to go to do missions, and between missions you can just fly wherever you want. The thing is, after Vice City, that genre kind of got bored, in my opinion. Disgaea 3, it's a Disgaea game, I freaking love Disgaea and it's really great. The coolest thing about this port is that they updated the graphics to look like Disgaea 4, so that's really cool. Dynasty Warriors next. What can I say, it's just Dynasty Warriors, but I do hate the touchscreen controls. They are absolutely annoying, but put aside that and it's an excellent game. Finally, a real Dynasty Warriors for a handheld system. Of course, I had to get Uncharted Golden Abyss. This is my least favorite Uncharted. It's still a good game. Not an A plus or an A or maybe a 9 or 8.5. The thing is, except for Nathan Drake, I didn't care about any of the characters. And of course, Sully and stuff. I don't even know what the girl's name is. I don't even know what the name of the enemy is. I just don't give a shit. Storyline, it also didn't interest me that much. I also didn't think there were great set pieces like in the other Uncharted games. But for a handheld and for a launch game, this is absolutely an amazing game. It looks beautiful. This is a launch game, BlazBlue Continuum Shift Extend. But here where I live, even though it's a launch game, they didn't have it at launch. Just weeks after launch, I could finally get this game. And it's just BlazBlue is freaking amazing. Unit 13. This is from the developers of SOCOM, Zipper Interactive, and as we know, Sony closed them down for the pretty much bad sales of Unit 13 and SOCOM 4. This game should have been SOCOM 4. If this game should have been or was SOCOM 4, SOCOM 4 would have been freaking amazing. But no, they wanted to do the Call of Duty style and totally fucked up SOCOM. And then they made Unit 13, that's pretty much SOCOM in a good way. This game is excellent. If you love tactical shooters, go get Unit 13. Little Defiance, it's pretty much a tech demo to showcase what the PlayStation Vita touch controls and touchpad can do. I played it a couple of times. I actually don't give a shit about this. Same goes with Reality Fighters. Because I couldn't get BlazBlue and I really wanted the fighter for my PS Vita, I was like, okay, I will get this game. No, I did play it for like 1 or 2 minutes and then I was like, ah, fuck this game, it's garbage. Maybe not now, but definitely last year, my most played game, Dungeon Hunter Alliance. I absolutely freaking love Diablo. Everyone is hating on Blizzard that they're gonna port Diablo 3 to the PS3 and the PS4. But I will say this, I will get the PS3 version and the PlayStation 4 version. I freaking love Diablo. Diablo 3 may not be the best game, but it's, in my opinion, an amazing game. And Dungeon Hunter Alliance reminds me of Diablo, but worse. It's not a bad game, but I definitely love this game. It's a really great game and stuff. But something about this, I don't know, maybe the storyline, or maybe just the really bland characters, bland weapons, bland environments, but this is one of my most played games on the Vita. It's a great game. It's just like Diablo. So yeah, there are a lot of games like this actually. And what I hated about this is that on the smartphones, you can, or like iPhone, you can get this game for, what is it? $7. This game cost me 40 euros. Holy shit. Rip off. The game I bought this year is of course Ragnarok Odyssey. I was waiting for the European release. And it has been released on the PlayStation Network and only on the PlayStation Network. And I was like, actually, on Facebook, you know, the developers are on Facebook and like, ah, Ragnarok Odyssey is, you know, been released on the PlayStation Network. I was like, whatever, dude, I will get the American version and you will not get my money because it's not boxed. And they were like, yeah, we don't have much money, we cannot make it boxed. I'm like, ah, crap, you're just bullshitting, but doesn't really matter. So I got the game from the United States and it's a good game. It's at the moment my most played game this year. And it reminds me of Phantasy Star meets Monster Hunter, but then with limited customization. You can only customize your weapon, and you can only wield one weapon for every character class, and there are only 6 character classes, so that's not a lot of customization. It does look good, it does sounds good, and it plays much faster than Monster Hunter and Phantasy Star Portable. Street Fighter X Tekken, I freaking love this game. I didn't actually play Street Fighter X Tekken on my PS3 that much. I don't know why, because I was really looking forward to it. I was like, oh my god, you know, Tekken versus Street Fighter, finally! And I didn't play that much, but I can guarantee you I am playing this game a lot on my Vita. At the moment, more BlazBlue and Rocket Odyssey, but you know, when the game came out, I got it and I freaking love it. I love Tekken, I love Street Fighter, and together they're just invincible. Well, if you can like put Guilty Gear with BlazBlue. Okay. New Little King Story. Last year I got to Game Expo. I got this game because I was looking out for it, because I saw some videos on the Wii, because it's a port from the Wii, and I was like, looks pretty good, kingdom management and doing quests and this and that. And then I played this game, I was like, oh, this is a pretty cool game, until I got like 8 characters on screen. And I think the frame rate drops to like 1, 2, or 3. And I was like, what? The PlayStation Vita could easily handle this game. I put it out my PlayStation Vita, put it back in a box, and I never played it again. Mod Nation Racer, it's still sealed. It was like only 11 euros. And anyway, it's just for my collection. I think that's it. Last and of course a little bit least, Army Corps of Hell. I played a couple of times, it's enjoyable, it's pretty cool. I love the music, I love heavy metal, so I love the music. Graphics are okay, a lot of blood, a lot of gore. It's definitely something different. And yeah, you can, if you can see it for like 10 euros, definitely try to pick it up. So these were my games I have at the moment for my PlayStation Vita. There are some Japanese games on the way, and like I said, this year there are quite a lot of games coming out for the PlayStation Vita finally. And with the E3 and Gamescom and Tokyo Show coming this year, I'll bet a lot of PlayStation Vita games will be announced. So I hope you enjoyed this video. Leave in the comments below, what are your games? What type of games do you have on your PlayStation Vita? What is your PlayStation Vita collection? Or leave a video response, doesn't really matter. And of course, I will see you next time.